All right, so I'm at the Goodwill bins, and I'm backing my van into position now to pick up another giant box of stuff. If you haven't been watching the channel for very long, you may not remember, but we bought a giant box full of keychains and jewelry here at the Goodwill bins in our town of Phoenix. And here on the channel, we went through that box and found lots of treasures. I'm talking tons of valuable keychains, lots of jewelry, coins, even found an Apple Watch, crazy stuff. We're getting another one of those boxes today with slightly different content, so stick around, it's gonna be fun. What do you think about that? It's a pallet full of the good stuff. Can't wait to dig through it. I'm very excited about these kinds of episodes. The last one was a success. Hopefully this one will be also. Before we get started, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. We're gonna be doing a lot more of these pallets in the near future. It's gonna be exciting. I know generally what's in here. I got to peek at the top, but I don't know exactly what's in there. I don't know what's on the bottom. So stick around, we're gonna dig into it. We're gonna hopefully go home with some super awesome stuff. Okay, the hard part, I think, of this whole day is gonna be getting this bad boy out of here. Last time we did it, we kind of spilled some of it on the ground. It was a little bit difficult. I don't really have like a ramp system to pull it down on. But it's not the heaviest thing in the world. You see, I can move it around. So I'm thinking what I'm gonna do, and this is gonna get a little hairy, I think I'm just gonna grab the pallet, and I'm gonna yoink it out of it. And then once it's on the ground, we'll just drag it wherever we need to. But hopefully it stays on the pallet on the course of the yoinking. Do you think it will? During the course of the yoinking?
The yoinking, yeah.
I'm gonna yoink it. Okay, are you ready?
Yes.
I gotta go hard though. Like, it's gotta come all the way out. If I like stop, it's gonna tip.
Yeah.
And crush me.
Okay, don't crush yourself.
I don't wanna die by a giant box of stuffed animals. Are you ready?
Do it.
All right, here we go. Here we go. Oh, yoink! That wasn't bad. That wasn't really bad. Was it?
No. I mean, the pallet's ripped, but...
Well, the pallet was always going to be ripped. All right, you guys ready to see what's in here?
Let's do it.
Look at this. So here's the thing. When the Goodwill bins sells these pallets full of stuff, you're not allowed... It's like storage containers or storage units when you go bid on them and stuff. Like, you can peek in, no touching. If there's enough of what you want on the top or on the surface, you can buy it. We paid $25 for this box. And honestly, it's a little bit of a gamble because most of what you see here is not in the realm of what we resell in our antique mall. Like, we don't sell non-specific, nonsense. Like, we don't sell generic bears. That's not what we do. We sell Power Rangers, Pops. We sell the franchise stuff, right? So there's no telling if there's any of that in here. Now, the one thing that made me say, okay, let's buy, and I don't know if I'll be able to find it now because I don't know which side of the box is which anymore. There's a couple things that I was able to see on top where I was like, ooh, that could do me good. I didn't see that. That's pretty cool. There was some Pez in here is what there was. I saw one Pez in particular where I was like, ooh, that's kind of ugly. I wonder where that Pez went. Well, in the course of digging through this box, we'll find the Pez that I saw while we were at the Goodwill bins. But here's what we got to do today. Here's today's goal. We got to get everything out of this box. We're going to throw some of it away that's not salvageable. Unfortunately, this Mickey has been too well loved. So that'll just get tossed. And we're going to make a pile of stuff to go donate to some mom and pop. Hannah's pointing at something. A Pez. Ooh. That's pretty cool. There's inevitably going to be a bunch of Pez in here because I saw a pile of them, and the pile of Pez is what made me go, okay, we'll buy. But we got to get a pile of stuff that's like, we're going to go donate to like a mom and pop thrift store. We got to get a pile of stuff that's like, yes, this is going in our antique mall booths. And then a pile of stuff that like is in the middle. We're not undecided. There's gonna be some weird stuff in here. This is, you know what this is more gonna be like? Because honestly, this stuff right here is what would get dumped into a bin at the Goodwill bins. If you've been watching our channel, you know all about the bins videos. You know all about the garbage we go to the bins and dig through. This is almost gonna be like if we went to the Goodwill bins and we had our own bin, and we got to dig through every inch of it and show you everything that's in a single Goodwill bin. And I think that's interesting because you don't get that opportunity. When you're at the Goodwill bins and shopping regularly, it's a rush. It's a, oh God, I gotta get to the bottom. But this is how, what this box you're looking at is, this was sent to the Goodwill bins from a regular Goodwill store, right? And this is, when you go donate stuff to the Goodwill, they try to sort some stuff into like, oh, toys and stuffed animals in this box and clothes in that box. And if it's overstock, and they don't, and they've got 16 of these boxes and they only need one to restock the store this week, they'll send the rest of the 15 to the Goodwill bins. This happens all over the country. The Goodwill bins, if they get too stocked up and they can't keep them all, they start selling them off like this. So just so you know before we get started, that's what this nonsense is. Now, before we dig in, I want to get it over here on the side of the van. What am I going to do, drag it?
I guess so. Bend over, big boy.
Okay. Okay. Okay, so I'm kind of not nervous, but I'm just like, I don't know what's going to be in here. And I don't know what to keep, what not to keep. I just don't know. I mean, there's some things that are pretty cool. There's some puppets. My hand's way too big for it. But this is some stuff we're going to keep any puppets that are in here. For sure, because I'm going to start selling some puppets in one of our antique malls. But some of this is just so ratty and torn up, there's no fixing it. I just found the Pez we were discussing.
Oh, wow.
I don't know that that's a $25 Pez, but that alone, especially since we've been selling specifically Pez in one of our antique malls, that's almost going to pay for the box. So we got to get some IKEA bags out. And I've got several of these today. And like, this is just gonna be our awesome bag. This is gonna be the price immediately take to the antique mall. Hannah, why don't you tell us how you feel about this though? Take a little dig.
I'm a little overwhelmed.
See what you see.
There's so many more Pez.
Is that a, yeah, look at that.
Ooh, Spider-Man. Oh, cabbage patch.
Right.
Is that like a makeshift diaper? Weird.
Weird, that's very weird. Don't look inside.
Nope.
There's a not Pez.
Yeah, they're like, there's a, what is it, dispense?
They're just, yeah, some other candy dispenser.
Weird. So I'm excited. I want to see what's in the bottom of this thing.
All right, well, let's set the camera aside and point it at the box, and let's just start digging.
Let's do it.
I'm pretty excited about this. We're gonna try to get through this without being disturbed, but we are sitting by the trash can, so there's inevitably gonna be about 10 people while we're here dumping their trash, and they're all gonna be like, what are you doing? The real fear is that someone comes up and thinks that this is already trash and decides to jump in with us, like they could have some too. I mean, we'd tell them no if that happens, but it wouldn't surprise me. There's some trash diggers around here, myself included. All right, let's do it. That's a big lull right there. That's the favorite puppet I've ever seen. Here. Moo, I think. I think I'm a cow. I don't know. Look at this puppet.
Oh, it's so cute.
So, there's so many puppets. This puppet has a watch on. Well, that's broken. I didn't even consider the possibility of there being Beanie Babies. Yeah. Oh, baby. Oh, baby. Paddington, let's go. All right, initial reaction of what's in the bin. An insane number of puppets, and of course, just a crap ton of Pez. We keep finding more and more Pez. Both of these things are quite specifically awesome, and we'll discuss why here in a bit. This lamb's hair has come unraveled. Everywhere in the box. That's
That's garbage right there.
Oh no!
It's broken a little bit. Maybe I can fix it. Oh, sweet. Oh, it's broken. Dang it. That would have been good.
It's a kettle dog.
Oh, wow. Local air conditioning place. Their catchphrase is, it'll keep you cool, but it's hard to spell. I hear that every day on the radio. Ooh, more Beanie Baby. It's a Beanie Baby Olaf. A bag full of potato head.
Oh my gosh.
Something big.
Yoink. Oh wow.
That's frightening.
Mm. Oh.
Oh, beautiful.
Kid. Here, take that.
Probably the better finds yet.
Okay, this next bit is the exciting bit. Look at this. See how it's about 3/4 of the way down? What has happened is in the course of this thing being transported from Goodwill to Benz to here, etc., forklifts, up, down, all the little stuff has descended to the bottom. So here's a great example. Thomas the Tank stuff, right? I'm hoping, oh look, Mario stuff. I'm honestly gonna be surprised if the smaller stuff on the bottom is not better than the big stuff on top. Now don't get me wrong, we've already found like several Cabbage Patch dolls, dressed and undressed, so like that's probably already some good profit for us. But you guys know what I like. You guys know I like the Legos, the Beyblades, the Thomas the Tank, the little stuff that I sell at my antique booth. So I tell you what I'm gonna do. Hannah, you're gonna step off, you're standing on the pallet. I'm gonna drag this bad boy over to the trash can so we're close by it. I'm gonna start shoveling the trash out of here into the trash can. I gotta crawl inside, is what I'm saying. And believe me, a lot of what's left here is trash. The small stuff is usually, sometimes literally, trash. Not just stuff you can't resell, but like, there's probably gonna be some trash in here. All right, let's do it. You ready? Let's do it. Like literal trash. Literal trash. Well, there's a lot of Duplo too. Ooh, there's a full Skylander. See what I mean? Small stuff coming up. Nightmare fuel giraffe. Let's not try to sell that to children.
Nope.
Blow dryer. Okay, I think I'm gonna actually need you to get me a bag just for Duplo.
Okay.
Get me a Duplo bag, because there's a lot of Duplo in here. Saw it.
It's next to that green thing.
Ooh, weird. Oh, this is awesome. Some CDs. We'll have to stick around to the end and see what's in there. Duplo. I want to keep the Duplo, but man, is it about to be a lot of work getting it all. Is that?
Just let, is it full?
Yeah, it's very full. Just let one of these be full of games. Shania Twain.
Shania Twain.
Here you go. This is a lot of fun because you know what they don't let you do at the Goodwill bins? They don't let you crawl inside.
They do not.
Step counter. ETA cuisine. Oh, Ratatouille Pez.
Sweet.
Hello Kitty Pez. The heck is that?
Vital Sassoon is hair products.
Vital Sassoon. Curlers! You want?
No.
Yuck. Oh, that's awesome.
Cool.
Set that down gently. We'll play that later. Eeyore. Spider-Man camera. Gatorade bottle. Oh, yes. Oh my God, when I bought this thing, me and someone were joking about there being Pokemon cards in here. Quick glance. Oh, I didn't believe there would be. The last box we bought had Pokemon cards in it.
It did.
You know, I guess there being bazillions and trillions of Pokemon cards on this earth, I guess statistically speaking, a box full of trash toys ending up at a dump like the bins. Statistically speaking. Why is it so hard to say statistically? My teeth get in the way. Statistically speaking, one would think there'd be a Pokemon or two in a box like this. There's two whole books. Well, this book's empty. Oh, baby. There's a couple reverse holos. There's a regular holo. I'm so pumped. Put those in the front seat of the van. I can't believe there are Pokemon cards in here. I'm not gonna try to piece that together.
Nope.
Are you smarter than a fifth grader? Weird. This is the medium bag. I got a bag full of stuff over there. They're like, I don't know what that is. We gotta look that up. Can't believe there are Pokemon cards. Now, ooh, that's awesome. Look at these homemade cassette tapes.
Wow.
I'll have to hold on to that too. Some of them are in Spanish. Cool. Last time we did one of these videos and did one of these boxes, we got down to the bottom, and of course there's like an iPod and an Apple Watch. Which, update on the Apple Watch, I got a charger for it if you watched the last video in this series. Apple Watch comes on and works, but there's two cables inside the Apple Watch. One to power it and for it to come on and transfer the data, and the other one for the touch response. The touch response cables is severed. So it comes on and works perfectly, except you can't touch it, which means it doesn't work perfectly at all. Not expecting to find an Apple Watch in the bottom of this bin, but there's all kinds of like baby bottles and stuff. But the Pokemon cards, that was awesome. Yes, a troll. So sometimes at the Goodwill bins, here's what we actually do. If we can reach the bottom of the bin, as you notice with this one, it's too tall for us to reach over into it. But the regular size bins at the Goodwill bins, we'll lean over and we'll rake the bottom, right? We'll touch almost every single piece, move it from one side to the other, grab all the little, what the heck? I did not know of this art form, the carved golf ball. Hang on to that. I've never seen that before. And we will, this is how we'll, face mask. This is how we'll not have to dig through and take out every single piece of what's left on the bottom. We'll just give it a couple once overs. Ooh, some glasses. And just make sure. And we'll do this a couple times to make sure we don't miss anything. You guys shout it out in the comments below if you see anything that we're missing. There's definitely always Legos on the bottom. There's definitely always Lego on the bottom of a bin. Without a doubt. Remember what that is. Hannah, you see anything?
Not yet.
Some wannabe Prada glasses.
Yes.
Ooh, Imagine X. That's good. All right, true story. My grandfather was a traveling bricklayer, and my grandmother and he helped my father raise me, so we spent a lot of time with my grandmother. And while my grandfather and my dad would travel for their bricklaying job all around the country, we'd sometimes travel to where they were to visit them. And one of the youngest memories I have in my brain, which is as always, I always find these conversations interesting. Hannah, can you remember your earliest memory-ish? Do you have roughly an idea of what it is? I mean, I don't think any of us are quite certain we're right about which one's our earliest.
Right.
Mine involves one of these.
Mine, the one that's the strongest is the day that I, like, was absolutely horribly distraught that I couldn't go to preschool because I was sick.
Oh, that sucks.
Yeah.
Well, that's the opposite. I didn't want to go to preschool for nothing. Mine was, we were in like Michigan, somewhere pretty far from home for us, far-ish. I mean, we live in Kentucky, so it's like 8, 9, 10 hours, something like that. But we went up to visit my dad and grandfather where they were working, I think building a smokestack. They usually worked on mills, paper mills, or power plants, stuff like that. And for whatever reason, I don't actually remember making the bottle, really. But we went to like a fair thing in the parking lot of a grocery store or something, you know how they do in the Midwest. And me and my sister got to make one of these. I think my little brother might not have even been born yet. So it was my oldest sister. And what I remember, though, is in the middle of the night, us waking up to a crash of a bottle. My grandfather had gotten up in the middle of the night to go pee-pee and knocked mine off the shelf. And I cried like a baby. I mean, just, I was a baby. I just screamed. I was so mad. My sister gave me hers, I think, which was something for her. She's usually not that nice, but I guess... I guess she was feeling bad for me that day. Sand bottles. You guys remember those? Comment below. Comment that below or comment below. Maybe if you remember, you can tell us your earliest memory. But this one's mixed up a bit, you know? Because, like, when you do them right, they separate.
Right.
At least they separated pretty well. I think they left a little bit too much room in that one. But I like how they just glued some hair on the top.
Cute.
Great idea. Good use of a hot glue gun. Well, that's a day too late.
Rip.
As of shooting this, Halloween was yesterday, so there's that. And there's some Christmas ribbon, which I guess we could keep for the next holiday come around, but look at this dirtiness.
Yep.
As soon as I'm done with this, I'm going straight to take a shower. It's pretty dirty stuff. Alright, let's do another pass on this bottom. Just make sure we see all of it. Ooh, there's a couple keychains. All right, tape, one single Thomas the Tank, Thomas and Friends track, bottle opener, keychain for a local brewery, a single ninja, looks like a ninja turtle, ninja the foot, one single lifesaver, tell me if you see anything.
Lego wheels.
Lego wheels. Broken coffee cup.
Aw.
You know, there's a guy that drops by our videos once a month or so, and he always comments something really negative. And it's almost always the same thing. He always says, these guys are stupid. And he said it several times, a couple of trash pickers. And I for the life of me, because the way he keeps wording it, I can't tell if he is calling us trash at what we do, like we're not good at it, or if he just is calling us trash pickers as in like they dig in trash and that's disgusting and unattractive within and of itself. Because of the way that this guy keeps... Now, mind you, he's not smart enough to get out of the spam filter. A lot of people that come by and drop negative stuff, it never even gets out of the held for review folder. But that's what makes me think about this in here. Like, I wonder if he looks at... I guess some people look at us digging through trash like I do, like some of you do, and just go, terrible humans. Which makes me laugh, because... As dirty and ridiculous as this is, I find a lot of enjoyment in this, you know? But I always want to ask the guy if he means we're trash at this or if he's using trash people as an insult. But if I reply, then I let him out of YouTube jail. And unfortunately for him, there's just something so funny to me about people screaming into the void thinking that they're contributing negatively to our community, and they're just screaming to themselves and no one else. So I don't let him out of jail, but some people don't get what we do, guys. And I'm not saying this for sympathy. Like, I'm not hurt by the guy or anything, but it is an interesting conversation. Some people are so uppity and so unaware of how some of us live that they come across videos like mine. Ooh, look, money and snow globe. They come across channels like ours and they're just like, and I say all that to say, I hope they come across this video, because do I not look like I'm in a trash can?
You're just a little gremlin.
like a trash panda, like a proper raccoon.
I'm gonna call you Oscar the Grouch all day.
Yeah, this is what I feel like right now. Some of this is gross. All right, I think what's left is trash. I get a little scared. The proper thing to do would be to just take it all out and make sure we sift through it. But that, you're talking about extra hours of work. But here's what happens here. If I start lifting these up, the stuff's gonna fall out. But there's inevitably like Legos under there and other little stuff. So at the Goodwill bins, this happens all the time. If you're able to flip a whole bin into another one, what's left on the bottom, like I've already said, is some good stuff. But like, you start getting to like the stuff that's falling through the cracks underneath the bin, and you start finding some really special stuff. Sometimes, not all the time. Sometimes it's a waste of time. But I think that's it. I think we've done it. I think we're gonna turn the camera off and dispose of the rest of this, and then we'll go inside and we'll talk about everything that we actually got out of there. This is exciting. Comment below if you saw anything that you would like to have. I know we've got a lot of antique mall resellers that have joined us on the channel. Anybody out there selling any of this nonsense, like Cabbage Patch stalls? We've never tried to sell any in our antique malls, but now that I've got like 10 of them, we just made. All right, that's good. Okay, bye. Where is our recycling bin? That one?
Yeah, it's the one facing the set.
All right, guys. We're in clean clothes now. We got pretty dirty rolling around in the trash, as I'm sure you can imagine. Let's talk a little bit about what just happened and how we're going to move forward with the new information we have, et cetera, et cetera. How did you feel about this box?
It was fun to dig through.
It's a lot of fun to bring a Goodwill bin home. If somehow you stumbled across this video and you're just watching this for the first time on our channel, we shop at the Goodwill bins regularly, which if you don't know, it's a store where you go to. They just have boxes of all the leftover stuff from the other Goodwills, as well as stuff they weren't even able to go through at the regular Goodwill stores. And as I've kind of mentioned, that's what this was. This is stuff that did never have a price tag on it. People donated it, and they had too much, so they're selling it in bulk. It's bulk overstock. And so that's cool. That's really, really cool. But it's like a gamble. I mean, the last time we did this, the gamble paid off. And I will say, I'll go ahead and say before we get into this today, it paid off. Probably not as high as a value as the jewelry box, keychain box we had last time, but that was very specific.
Yeah. I mean, there was a lot more stuff in that one because they're all so tiny.
Yeah. But at the same time, toys are more so what we do anyway. So we already have the infrastructure to sell this.
Right.
The other stuff we got, we had to build some infrastructure to sell the keychains. We had to kind of go out of our norm on some of our clothes selling apps to sell a couple of the other things to make a profit. But all this stuff we got out of this box will sell in the next couple weeks, because we sell so many toys. So it was good for us. But that being said, I want to talk about what we're going to do moving forward with this information, because our Goodwill bins has several other types of bins they sell, including electronics bins, clothing bins. And I'd like to know from you guys in the comments, would you like to see either of those? Which would you like to see more? We're going to do both. So I don't know which we're going to do next. Probably a clothing bin.
Yeah, I'd really like to do that.
We just need to do it to see how that goes. But also, our Goodwill bins really seems to be experimenting with things.
Yeah.
I guess Corona came along and knocked out some of their either normal ways they sell things, or just knocked down their dollar amount they were making, or
I think maybe there's a really good chance that some of the contracts that they had to sell off some of this stuff in bulk fell out from underneath of them. I'm making assumptions here. I know nothing. Let's be clear. But they're very clearly trying to claw back some of those pre-corona profits they used to have. So that's why this bulk selling that they've been doing has come along. That being said, I don't want to start relying on these boxes. I want to keep buying them, but I don't want to rely on them because I personally feel like there's a good chance come tomorrow they'll just stop doing it. Because yeah. I'd be interested to know if any of your bins do this bulk sell-off kind of thing, because ours has never done it, at least as long as we've been here. They could have been previous times, but you know, it's pretty tempting to say, hey, let's start buying boxes and open a store. I don't know. I've had conversations with people, very in-depth conversations about how this is such a great utility.
Yeah.
If there's an infinite number of clothing boxes, you could open your own thrift store, or you could at least, you know, get your own stock really easily in this way. I'm not sitting here suggesting we have a plan to open a store, but I'm just trying to explain. My mind kind of spends a lot of time thinking about this because it's such a great opportunity.
It's a unique opportunity because there is a whole lot of stuff you can get.
Yeah.
So, you know, it does beg the question, like, what could you do with all that?
Yeah,
kind of
so
stuff?
That's kind of the higher end. I've thought, man, the sky's limitless what you could do, or we could go start selling at flea markets and just buy a couple of these bins. I don't know. I'm just saying the possibilities are there, but at the same time, I don't want to jump into anything relying on them because I feel like they might, once everything blows over, they may not keep doing this.
Right.
We'll see. But for now, I definitely think we'll keep easing into it. I think we'll do a clothing bin next, and then maybe electronics bin. The electronic bin one scares me because of the weight. If it's full of computers and speakers and stuff.
Yeah.
I mean, my van can haul it. We can get it into my van, but we would probably have to bring it home and cut the box out.
Yeah, we wouldn't be able to get it out very easy.
Yeah, we wouldn't be able to pull it out of our van. We'd have to cut the box. So, I don't know. That's thoughts about the future, but I'm excited to show you guys what we got out of that box. There's a couple things that are actually really exciting and a couple things that are new for us. So let's jump right in and bury the lead. Two of these Pokemon books, and I just wanted to show you real quick. These will probably make another appearance on our weekly Pokemon episode, which actually, if you're watching this week's Pokemon, if you're watching this when we posted it, this week's Pokemon Monday video is up. It was a good one. We had a lot of cool stuff to look at. But I throw everything like this in a pile that I bring home on the channel, and then you guys send us stuff, and then we buy packs to open, and every Monday we go through all that stuff and pile stuff into our collection. A Dory.
Giant Dory!
Is she Disney, or is she aftermarket? She's aftermarket. She's a knockoff Dory. She is kind of cheap. She's like, I always call them bear toys.
Yeah.
They're foam and not cotton or not anything like that. We've got a lot to talk about here. There is definitely a market for Cabbage Patch dolls. Now, I will say there are definitely some people at our Goodwill bins that I have seen get Cabbage Patch dolls on the regular. I've never really had an in-depth enough conversation with them. Have you? To know what they do with them. But there's definitely always this one or two women that I've seen that they snatch up everyone they see. And I've always thought about grabbing one or two to put in our antique malls, because I definitely see them in our antique malls that we sell in. But you know why I've never brought one home?
Why?
I don't know if I've ever seen one with the clothes on.
Yeah, and whenever I've done research on them before, because I've picked them up at the bins, and I was like, well, maybe they're worth something. Mm-hmm. They're pretty much worthless without clothes.
Exactly. And, I mean, I guess that can be said about a lot of dolls, a lot of Bratz dolls, kind of like that. So, we have several clothed Bratz dolls.
Cabbage Patch dolls.
I'm going to probably do that 5 times now. And very nicely dressed, too. Like, a red pair of corduroys? How does that show up?
Do you know how much I wish that I had those in my life? Like
the actual corduroy? Me. Yeah, you need a Wumbo Ray for those.
I do!
So as we dig through here, you'll see there are several more in various states of being clothed or disrobed. The real diaper kind of weirds me out.
Yep.
That's a beautiful Beanie Baby.
Did you have that one growing up?
No, I didn't have any. I mean, I had the McDonald's ones. I didn't have the real ones like you did.
Interesting.
Rich kids.
I'll tell you what, my neighbor actually had a ton of them, and she, every year for Christmas, would give us one. So that's kind of how I got so many of them.
So your rich neighbor would give you her hand-me-downs.
Kind of.
Last year's Christmas ones. Look at this head-banging goat horse.
So many puppets in here. It's crazy.
What? Let's take a vote. Comments below. What animal is this? What is that supposed to be? There's a lot of hand puppets in here, and we're not going to sit here and you know, look at all of them. These were the weirdest ones. I found this to be very strange. You stick your hand in his head through the back. And then the batteries are dead, but there's an electronic device in the mouth that... But isn't that the goofiest looking puppet you've ever seen?
He's really adorable.
So, I've already talked about this just briefly in the past. I have a huge collection of puppets. Not like I collect them, but I've been piling them up for a while. For various reasons. For multiple reasons we don't need to get into. But one of those reasons that we can talk about is that I was going to start reselling them in our antique malls. So that being said, I was thinking about, you know how sometimes you go to Walmart used to, I don't think they do this exactly anymore, but there'd be a bin, but it's like a wire bin. Maybe it's like the thing they put the rubber, cheap rubber balls in at like Walmart. I was thinking about getting a yellow bin, wiry bin for our antique mall and just filling it with puppets to the top. So you can dig around in it and dig out the one you want and all the goofy puppets are in there.
I feel like the more things that people can dig through, the better.
Yeah.
It's fun.
Well, if you take a look at my toy booths and the way that I've designed them, I've tried to make it that way. Like with our Lego tables, I want you to go in and get your own. There are lots of different theories on reselling and how to stock a store and stuff, and we could talk at length and disagree endlessly and agree on other things endlessly. But I always feel like when I make my store, our antique malls, I want it to be a messy, kind of lean towards the messy experience, the overloaded dig through stuff to find something. So I think that might be something I'm going to work on for the next month or so. I need to find the right crate bin kind of thing that, A, you walk by and go, oh my God, that's full of puppets. What the crap? And then you got to go dig through it. I haven't tried to sell any puppets at our antique malls. I think if I did, the stuff that would probably actually sell is like the stuff geared towards almost babies. You know, this stuff is not the cheapest new in store. I forget this brand, but there's two or three different kiddie brands of these puppets that are actually quite expensive new, and I have several of them. So that's what a lot of the rest of this is in this particular bag. You'll also see Pez all over the place. Every single one of these bags we're about to show you has Pez in it. That's probably, I think I'm going to set that aside for my find of the day.
Yeah.
You can set yourself aside one. Now here's another one that was weird, another puppet. And some of this stuff, mind you, we're going to have to look a lot of stuff up. I set several things aside. I was like, I have no idea if there's any value here or not. I have no clue. Most of it I want to assume no, but we're going to look it up. So here's Pavlov. So he's a dog. Pavlov's dog. If you don't know what that is, go to college, I guess. I don't know. Just Google it. But he has... I noticed it first because he has a watch on that says Pavlov. And I was like, oh, he's a dog. Pavlov's dog. He's got a watch. And then I looked and I was like, oh, his name is Pavlov. Okay. At first, this watch actually looked proper and real. I mean, you look closer now, you see that it's not. That's what caught my attention. I thought it was a real watch at first. I was like, that's really strange, this puppet with a watch. Right? So that's probably one of the cooler puppets that we found. So many hand puppets. And this stuff, for a dollar a piece and a bin full of them, will probably sell pretty well. And that's a Grumpy Cat puppet.
Oh, Grumpy Cat!
Rest in peace. Oh. He died. If you didn't know, sorry to ruin your day. That's a pretty good one. My hands are too big for all these puppets. Hey! Wow! Wow!
You have to say something condescending.
Go to college! Actually, don't. It's too expensive! I've spent some time in my life puppeteering. I like experimenting with the facial movements. That's probably one of my favorites too. But yeah, forget all the rest of the nonsense I just said. We're gonna try to find a way to sell some of the specific ones, and we're gonna have to go to our storage unit in the coming days, weeks, and clean it out, and I'll have to dig out the tub and show you, but we've got a pretty large store of puppets in there. Wouldn't it be pretty cool, one of our toy booths, just like a display all around the top wall where it's just like the nice puppets?
Yeah.
I'm probably the only one. I'm probably a crazy person. So this is Pooh Bear, right?
He looks like a very old Pooh Bear, but he doesn't have his shirt, so there's no way to tell.
It is wind up, things broken, but yeah, we're pretty sure it's Pooh Bear. A couple clocks in here for me to customize. You guys already know about that. Heck, I can probably make more than our money back on this box just customizing this the way that I do. And
for sure.
Selling our antique mall. Yet but another Cabbage Patch, so.
That is, I wish I had that outfit.
You'd rock it?
Some rad 80s outfits.
So, look at this. I don't think this came on this bear. SLC punk leather jacket, right? And I thought that was crazy when I saw that, but I was like, why is it on this teddy bear? I don't know what's going on there. But that's pretty cool. That's pretty cool.
Interesting.
Olaf, just because all the Disney stuff sells in our booth.
Oh, for sure.
Oh, this was, I was trying to tell Hannah about this. I glazed right over it whenever we were filming and digging through the box. But, you know, a regular old Dale Earnhardt. Rest in peace, number 3. Just nonsense we couldn't throw away. I don't know what these are. There's a whole bag of stuff here, worth of stuff here that, like, I don't think is valuable. We're going to Google it just to make sure. It honestly looks very homemade.
They're interesting. Yeah, there was a couple of these.
Yeah, but they look almost entirely homemade, so I don't think it's anything branded. And, like, this is actually old and gross, and I shouldn't have kept it, but, like, I just don't know what it is. Maybe it's some college alma mater thing. I don't know. I remember this from when I was a kid, though. Do you know what this is? It's from...
It's like I recognize him, but I don't know.
It's from, like, either Cinderella or one of those mouse movies. I don't know. Doesn't it look like one of the little mice from Cinderella?
For sure, yeah.
I don't know, maybe one of you guys will know, comment below. There was a little bit of Nerf stuff in there, not a lot. Pez, Thomas the Tank, yada, yada, yada. So let's go through another bag and make sure you're setting the Cabbage Patch aside, because I want to lay them all out when we're done.
Okay.
This has been, so far though, it's like, there's obviously more than $25 worth of value there, which is what we paid for this bin. I don't know if we've made that clear up at this point. Isn't that what we paid? Yeah, $25 for this one. We pay a little more for the last one, but the toy ones are pretty cheap. I don't do any business with board games, but it's another one I couldn't bring myself to throw away. We haven't went and dumped all that leftover stuff off at Goodwill yet, so if we do, I'll probably include this. But it felt pretty complete. It looks complete-ish. It looks like maybe it's missing the pieces, but they could be under the box. I don't know. We'll look. We'll see. I almost jacked you in the face of that box, didn't I? Again, just more plushies that we're like, all right, it looks keepable. Set it aside. Now, here's the curious part. These CDs. Point of Grace.
Don't know that one.
Disc number 7. We'll have to just put it in. Bolero. A bunch of burnt discs in this one. Discs, all kinds of discs, 4, 5, 6, 7. I wonder if it's somebody's like, were they DVDs or CDs? I didn't even look. CDRs. Curious.
People's mixtapes.
Pantera. You guys definitely comment below if you see anything good. If you see anything that you want to recommend, we'll pop it in. Actually, I don't even know if we have a CD player, to be completely honest.
That's highly unlikely, actually.
I have external disc drives to plug into my MacBook. Shania Twain. Tracy Bird.
Lots of Tracys.
That's good. Tracy Bird. Glam rock. Cool. Harley Davidson. Harley Davidson road songs. I'll have to give those to my dad. See if he wants them.
Oh, No Doubt CD.
Yeah, sweet. Lords of Acid. That was pretty neat. For that to be in the bottom of that bin. Reader's Digest. Sweet. So audiobooks.
Old Navy? What?
Okay, some sort of Old Navy mix, MCA, George Strait. Okay, more Reader's Digest. I personally can honestly say I had no idea that Reader's Digest put anything on CD. I mean, I guess it makes sense. You guys ever come across Reader's Digest books at the thrift? Back when our bins had hella books prior to the Rona. I guess I just feel like calling it the Rona today. Is it like the third time I've said that? There were tons of books all the time, and half of them sometimes would be Reader's Digest. It would either be Reader's Digest or National Geographic. A strange, old, there were several just incredibly old stuffed animals and handmade. This is handmade just like those other ones. You want to place a miniature pool? We spilt it. I tried not to spill it, but I knew we would. More really old handmaids. Well, I'm not sure some of it's handmade. I mean, it is. It's hand machine made. I don't know if it's hand stitched, but like someone put that thing together. Pez, always nice. A leash, some tapes. I keep finding this at the bins. It's some knockoff Scrabble game.
Banana words.
Yeah, banana words. Is that what it says?
No.
Bananagrams. Couple Skylander. This is probably one of the better finds. I wish there were more of that kind of thing in there, but that's what you look for on the bottom of the bin. What even is this? Oh, it's those tapes.
Oh, okay.
They're all very yellowed. All right, next bag. I'm going to put this on my troll. Hold on, is that troll in this bag? Yes, I'm going to put these both on my troll shelf. I have a troll shelf because I'm a grown man. All right. I have no idea. We did this early in the morning, and then we went out and did chores and got chores done and then came back to finish this. So I kind of like already some of the specifics of what was in there. I'm like, I don't know. That was another one where I was just like, I can't throw this away. It's too nice. It's a very nice one. www.wildrepublic.com.
Interesting.
Cool. Poodle.
No.
I don't see any tags. Good chance that it's handmade. I mean, what's with some of these handmade ones? Puff.
Puff the Magic Dragon.
Not, you know, but...
You know. For children.
The number of times we get comments on this channel, they're like, are you guys high? Are you guys smoking? I think sometimes...
No, we're just weird.
We just, yeah. I guess some people are like, you'd have to be high to go do what these people are doing. It's a frog puppet, but it doesn't have a moving mouth. That's pretty weird.
Lame.
Also potentially handmade. I mean, I don't know if you guys... I might be wrong on some of that stuff being handmade, but... You can look at stitches sometimes and just see a machine did that, somebody did that by hand, and then a lot of that looks like hand stitching. Probably another one of the more exciting finds. She needs a little cleanup, but bubbles, a very heavy, it's very substantial. Feel how heavy that is.
That's surprising.
Yeah,
there were like scarecrow bubbles.
I don't know. I guess some sort of Halloween edition. A bag full of Mr. Potato Head stuff. I'm pretty happy about that actually. Toy go back and forth. You guys know how in one of our toy booths we have the build your own Legos tables. I always thought about doing that with a potato head. But it's not like, that's not a money maker because people want to build their own Mr. Potato Head. But the hope would be that parents come to shop for antiques, they bring their kids, and to quell them to say, okay, you can get something. Sure, put your own potato head together. I've thought about that on and off for years. It's not really something I plan on making any moves towards, but if I want to, there's a good start. More Pez. This was really cool. I'll probably just actually put this together. It's a 3D metal model of the Millennium Falcon.
Sweet.
Yeah, really cool. I've never put one of these together before, so I'm going to actually set that aside. The Pez in here kind of date these bags. It's all kind of the same era animation stuff. You know?
It is.
It really is. It's kind of funny. The lone Nerf gun. Another Beanie Baby. We don't currently sell Beanie Babies. We've been hoarding a little bit of it. We wanted to make some very nostalgia-heavy Beanie Baby videos, so we bought some specific stuff for our other channel and some other stuff we were going to do. But we have noticed that a couple dealers and a couple antique malls we frequent and or sell at, that some people do okay with it. Of course, they sell it pretty cheap, so you're gonna have to acquire it in a manner like this to sell it that cheap. That's another reason to potentially continue to buy these toy bins. There's several things like that we could potentially hoard up and sell at our antique malls. This lightsaber's busted, but these usually sell pretty well at our antique mall. And actually, all that's broken is a little joint there. Oh, actually, now that I'm looking at it, this is completely fixable. I can fix this.
Sweet.
I just gotta knock out that post and put that back in and then secure it back in. It'll be good as new. Very cool. Frog. All right. Is there any more bags or is that it?
That's it.
Okay. So how many? There's one more. One more bag. I don't remember if there's any more. I don't remember if there's any more Cabbage Patch in this bag or not. But we'll see. So this was interesting. I got excited because I saw Thomas and Friends. It's a Thomas and Friends take-along bag. But it's got, like, mummy army men in it.
Weird.
Very strange. And this was another... This was just such high quality. I'm going to have to go to wide on this. He was so high quality in his hoodie and everything. And he's heavy and he's very substantial. Like, Gund Inc. I don't know anything about some of this. Wish Bear Hope.
Interesting.
Made in limited edition for May department stores.
Interesting.
So it's another one of those things, and we just kind of did all this work today, like, on the fly. We're going to have to Google that, make sure it's not valuable. I don't imagine that it is, but much like anything else we bring home from the thrift store, we're definitely going to double check before we list it or throw it away or re-donate it. A nonsense stuffed animal. Nondescript. Monkey puppet. More Pez, more clocks, more what the heck is this? I need to Google it. CH, like no tags on any of it. Kind of handmade looking. I knew there was another Cabbage Patch. And there's a couple items of clothing that I don't know if they're just rando stuffed animal or Cabbage Patch, but she's got some PJs on.
Are those Cabbage Patch PJs?
I don't have any idea. No,
this is like a... It's like a
human
PJ.
A human PJ? Actual baby clothes?
Yeah.
This is pretty cool. That'll sell. We just sold some, like, Disney and other... over the last weekend, I had stocked a bunch of stuff in one of our antique malls, like Bear in the Big Blue House and so... And it all sold, so I'm going to replace it with some of this. I think there's some more clothes in here. Again, is it actual... I think these are actual baby clothes.
Yeah.
More puppets. Yes.
That's what was quacking.
Did you hear it?
I did.
That's funny. Okay. I think that's it. More puppets for the potential puppet bin. I'm going to set this over here. Get the Cabbage Patch dolls back on the table, and we'll re-examine those. I'm not excited because, like, these are going to bring us a fortune or anything. They're definitely something very specific that people collect. And we'll be able to put them in our antique mall. And we'll be able to make a few bucks here on these. I think we'll make a few bucks on these. The Pez dollar piece. And then, what was the other stuff? Just the puppets at a couple dollars a piece. I think the key to selling puppets in the future, when I get around to doing that, are really going to be just having bulk puppets for people to dig through. Go, oh, I'll get this one for little Jeffrey. I don't know who names their kids Jeffrey anymore. If your name's Jeffrey, don't rage in the comments. I'm sorry. It's a bad joke. Does this come out of its mouth?
It should.
Well, it really wants it.
Don't take my passy.
It came out. It was not easy, though.
Put that back in. It was like abuse.
Did it look bad?
No, it's just like...
That's funny. A couple of them are really nice, like this one. You guys will have to hit the subscribe button, turn those notifications on, and we'll definitely put these in our antique malls for whatever price we research them to be at, and you can definitely check later on with us and see if they made any money, if this was worth it or not. That was definitely worth it for the experience. I think the next time that we go to the bins... And there are toy bins that are potentially going to go home with us. I think what I'll do is just be a little bit more deliberate and kind of looking, is there something valuable on top? If so, I'll take it. If not, maybe not. Because I don't know. I mean, because there's definitely pretty much everything we just showed you. We'll sell at our antique malls, a few bucks each. Like, we're definitely going to make, pending how much these Cabbage Patch dolls, they could be $10 a piece or $50 piece. I really don't know. I have very limited knowledge here on this specifically, but these two have branded clothing, so I'm hoping they're towards the higher end. But that could make a lot of money. If not, we're not losing money here. We'll make $100-$150 off all this, minimal. Hopefully more with the dolls. But I'm not as like excited about it as I am the keychain. If I saw another box of jewelry keychain nonsense like the last episode doing this, like, I would pay whatever they wanted for it. You know, I'd be very excited about it. The toys, I don't know. It's just not... I'm not mad we did this. I'm not let down. It's just not quite the same. I guess what we'll do is we'll do the clothes next, and we'll just rotate through one of each type of bin they have, and we'll come back around. Just keep going in circles and just see how it goes.
Yeah.
Because this is a little bit more risky, but I guess I think it's worth the risk. Because if you buy 10 toy bins, eventually one of them's going to be full of Nerf guns.
Yeah, true.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, I feel like one of them's got to have at least one thing in it that's just, like, super awesome.
Yeah, but... yeah, but for me, the awesome thing here is the Cabbage Patch dolls. Hold them up.
Unexpected, but yes, super cool.
Cover photo.
Did you have any of these growing up?
We did. We had two of them. I had one that looked like her, but she was brunette.
My grandmother had some in box at my childhood home upstairs. I don't know why, but I knew what they were because I remember seeing them when I was growing up. Will you guys comment below? Let me know if you spot anything in any of that bin that made you excited. Let me know what kind of bin you'd like to see us bring home next. We're doing this mostly for the experience. It's like 75%. This will be fun to dig through, make a video out of. 25%. Let's hope we make profit. It's really how we feel about it. Because it's just different than being at the bins. Bringing it home is pretty cool. So comment below. Let us know what kind of bin you'd like to see. A couple favors before we get out of here. There's a join button below this video. Go click it. See what's going on there. Some pretty cool stuff. Below the video, there's some links to also that join button if it doesn't show up for you. But also our public Discord. I would bet $1 million there's some people watching that collect these bad boys. Come over to the Discord today, post some pictures of yours, let us know why you collect them, or maybe if you don't collect them, resell them, I don't know. Let's talk about a little dollage today. We don't talk about dolls a whole lot on this channel. Bratz dolls, because that's what she's into, but we've never talked about any others, really. So if you collect Barbies or any other kind of dolls, let's chat about it on the Discord today, because you can't post pictures here on YouTube, right? Come over to the Discord, post pictures. Hit the subscribe button, help us get to 10,000 subs, we're on our way. We could really use your help. Potentially get there around the new year. It'd be pretty cool. What else am I missing? TendosTrash.com. Check out our merch store. That's it, guys. Thanks for hanging out with us today. Come back tomorrow. We've got some pretty cool videos for the rest of the week planned out, including a live video or two, maybe. So make sure those notifications are turned on so when we do those things, you can come back and hang out with us then. Until then, guys, peace out.